Hello everyone, in this video we are going to solve an example related to this phrase where it is being asked to calculate the maximum uniform loading that is acting on PQ member, and we are being given with the normal stress of 50 MPa and shear stress of 60 MPa at section XX of member RQ. So let's solve this example. Since the uniform loading intensity of W is acting on PQ member, therefore let's consider this PQ member and draw its free body diagram. So this PQ member is supported by hinge support at point P. It means it will be having two reactions. So let's name those reactions as RPV as the vertical reaction and RPH. At Q point, there's a pin support. The reaction of the pin support will be in the direction of the member QR. It means in this direction. So if you look at the previous figure, this is the direction of the QR member. It means the reaction will be making this angle. So using this right angle triangle, we can calculate this angle using 10 theta. This is perpendicular and this is base. So the angle will come out to be 53.13 degree. It means this reaction force will be making an angle of 53.13 with the PQ member. Let's represent this reaction at pit support as RQ. Now, in order to determine the reactions, we need to use the conditions of equilibrium. From all these three reactions, this is the reaction which will help us in determining the unknown, which is the uniformly distributed load of W. Because on QR member, we have been given with a stress. So let's use third condition of equilibrium, which is summation of all moments acting at any point equal to zero. Let's consider the P point. By considering the P point, what will be the benefit? The benefit will be we will be having zero moment created by these two reactions at P point, and then we can calculate the RQ force. Considering the clockwise moments as positive, so how many forces are acting on PQ member? These two reactions will be creating zero moment because of having zero moment down, but this RQ force will have some moment, and also this unknown uniformly distributed load of W will also be having some force. Let's represent that as W, which will be equal to distance multiplied by the loading intensity. Distance is 3, loading intensity is W. Now if you look at the RQ reaction, you can see that this force should be resolved into its two components as vertical and horizontal component so that we can have the momentum. So this vertical component will be creating zero moment because the line of action of this force is passing through P point. So then we will be having horizontal force, and let's represent that horizontal force as RQH. And the formula to calculate would be RQ multiplied by sine 53.13. Now moment caused by this force of 3W will be clockwise, so positive, and the distance would be half of 3, it means 1.5, but this horizontal component of RQ will be creating anti-clockwise moment, so negative RQ sine 53.13. How about the momentum? Momentum will be 3 equal to 0. Now from here we can have the value of RQ in terms of W, and when you do the calculations, it will be equal to 1.875 W. Now let's jump back to the previous figure. So at this cross section, we have been given with the normal and shear stress. Now we know the force which is acting through RQ member in terms of loading intensity. Now let's consider this RQ member then. So the reaction at this point is 1.875 W. So in order to have the balance, there should be an opposite force which would be acting at this point having the same magnitude of 1.875 W. Now the components, the horizontal and vertical component of this force will actually be normal and shear force. This would be normal force and this will be shear force. Now if you remember, this angle is 53.13. if you make it a right angle triangle, here it will be 90, then this angle would be 36.87. so this angle will also be 36.87. so let's name this horizontal component as V because this is shear force at XX section, and this as NXX because this is normal force at XX cross section. So VXX would be then equal to 1.875W multiplied by cos 36.87, because this is being calculated using the components. This vertical component would be then equal to 1.875W into sine 36.87. When you simplify it, VXX would be equal to 1.5W and NXX would be equal to 1.125W. Now, why we are doing it? We are doing it because we have been given with the normal and shear stress at this cross section. Then we can use the formula of stress, which is force upon area, and then we can calculate the W intensity. So now let's move on. The formula for the normal stress is normal force, which is in this case is NXX over area, and for shear stress the formula would be VXX over area. Now we have normal stress, we have shear stress, but we don't have area. We have the cross-sectional area, which means this cross-sectional area is given, but XX section is not at this point, or you can say vertical, exactly perpendicular. Therefore we need to know this area. So for this we need to consider a small right angle triangle. Let's enlarge this. So you can see we have been given that this RQ has a square cross section that has 30 millimeter each side. So this perpendicular side, this side is 30 mm, this is required. This is perpendicular side. So if this angle is 36.87, so this angle will also be the same. This angle I'm talking about, 36.87. So using sine theta formula, sine 36.87 perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Perpendicular in this case is 30, hypotenuse is required. So when you do the calculations, this unknown side would be 50 mm. Now this side is 50 mm, but if you see the cross section, the other side would be 30. It means the area would be 50 multiplied by 30. If you want to convert this into meter, then you need to divide with 1000. Then you're going to have the area as 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter square. I hope you are getting the concept of the area. This side is 50, but the other side is still same, which is 30. So therefore I use the formula as 50 by 30 instead of 30 by 30. If this would be the case, then in that case, the cross-sectional area would be 30 by 30. But this is the case where one side is 50, which we just calculated, but the other side is 30, which is not being changed, the other side. Now we will be having two formulas in terms of normal stress and shear stress. Let's do the calculation for normal stress first. So in case of normal stress, the value is 50 MPa. Force that we know from previous calculations, that is 1.125W divided by the area, which is 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 3. In this equation, you can see only W is variable. So on doing calculation, W would be 20 kilonewton per meter. And in case if we are talking about shear stress, where the value is 16 MPa, so now shear force is 1.5W divided by 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 3. And on doing calculations, we are going to have 16 kilonewton per meter. So we just have calculated the required value, which is the intensity of uniform loading acting at PQ member that was required in this question. So this is all from this video where we have learned calculating the intensity of the load at a member when normal stress and shear stress on another member is given. So this is all from this video. Thank you for watching this video.